Hello children, welcome you in class 10th subject IT 402 in the module 2 networking fundamentals from web application. This is the second module of web application chapter. It's a very important. This is one of the important session of this chapter, because in this chapter we will cover almost all the important topics, the points. The first we will see the networking fundamentals, the definition, then internet, advantages of internet, then network architecture. It's of two types, peer-to-peer, in short we say P2P also, and client-server architecture. Then advantages of networking, then ISP, Internet Service Provider. In this topics, within these topics we will cover a dial-up connection, broadband connection, the wireless connection, digital subscriber line, cable modem, etc. Then switching techniques. In switching techniques we have three types: circuit switching, message switching, packet switching. Then network devices. So many types of devices are there, but out of these only five important devices we will study here. That is switch, hub, router, bridge and repeater. Then types of networks. Out of five types, three types are important. These are LAN, local area network, metropolitan area network and wide area network. Then network layouts, and the last, it is related to the topology. Already you have some prior knowledge in class that you have studied, but in class 10th we will see in details these things. The four types we will study here: star topology, bus topology, ring topology and mesh topology. And the last of the chapter will be having self-assessment based on module 2. So let us see one by one, starting from computer network. So how to define this, the network? When we talk about the network, it means always two or more peripherals, computers or devices connected together to share the resources. The main purpose of network is to share resources and minimize the load. If we have 10 computers in the classroom and one printer, so how can we use that one printer for all the 10 computers? This we can do with the help of a network. So it is a set of computers connected together for the purpose of sharing resources. The most common resource shared today, connection, is internet. Other are printer and file server or other local server. Then first we see the internet, the basic definition. It is a collection of interconnected computer networks. It is a network of networks that consists of millions of private, public, academic and government networks together. Sitting anywhere in the world, we can communicate or connect with them. And how to work this? How the internet works? We have protocol TCP and IP. With the help of this protocol, the internet works. The IP is Internet Protocol. Each and every individual PC is given address, that is called protocol. It is a set of rules and regulations. And whatever the information we get on the computer, it comes in the form of packets. So TCP divides these packets, send the data, send packets of data to each other, the computer, from one computer to another computer. Then network architecture is very, very important. It refers how the computers are organized in a system and how tasks are allocated between these computers. So two types of architectures are there, peer-to-peer and client-server architecture. In peer-to-peer, we have the equal status of each and every computer. This type of construction we can see. Each and every computer has equal status. Here no server is there or no client. All computers are responsible for exchanging, receiving data from one another. All computers have equal status. It is very, very important. And there is no distinction between client and server computer. It is connected with the help of hub. So how will you define hub here? Hub is a central device in a network that provides a common connection among the computers or nodes. Second is client-server architecture. Here one server is there and others are clients. These all are clients. And all the clients are connected with the help of the internet from the server. So a computer which is responsible for providing services to other is called server, and the computers that uses these services are called clients. These are called clients, and this is called server, because the server is providing services to clients and clients are using services. The advantages of networking. Why do we network, use networking? So first important is user communication. Network allows user to communicate using email, social networking sites, video conferencing, etc. with the help of these medium, we can communicate from one to each other. Now file sharing, we can share any type of information, data, file, from one computer to another computer. We don't need to use any external devices for sharing the information. If the computers are networked, we can easily share the files. The hardware sharing, we can use the printer, scanner. The one printer can be shared to number of computers. The software sharing. By sharing the software over the network, large companies can reduce the cost of buying software. Instead of installing the separate computers, the software on individual computer, it's better to share the software with the help of networking. It reduces the cost and other resources also. The media and entertainment. Like the companies and TV channels use network to broadcast live radio and television programs. These are the advantages of networking. User communication, file sharing, hardware sharing, software sharing, and media and entertainment. Then ISP, very, very popular. Internet service providers. The company who provides internet services is called internet service provider. They can provide via wired or wireless also. These companies are BSNL, Airtel, Vodafone, Reliance, and Ideas, etc. Here there are two ways to connect to internet. One dial-up connection and another is B broadband connection. The dial-up connection carry less data, so in comparison to broadband connection, dial-up connection is the speed of broadband connection is measured in MBPS, megabits per second. And this is very important word, bandwidth. The bandwidth is nothing but the amount of data that a signal carry with it. We measure the speed of internet in terms of bandwidth. Broadband connection are of three types: cable modem, digital subscriber line, in short we can say DSL, and wireless connection. Wireless connection again divided into three categories: Wi-Fi, wireless fidelity, Wi-Fi hotspot, and WiMAX, worldwide interoperability for microwave access. It releases microwave signal. Then cable modem. It's a type of broadband connection that uses the cable television infrastructure. In cable modem, whatever the connection we have, the cable connection at our home, they use cable modem. Then DSL, in this connection the data is transmitted over wires. This is to be remembered, this wire term of a local telephone lines. Then wireless, this is a very popular technology nowadays. Here three different types are there: Wi-Fi, hotspot, and WiMAX. It is a popular technology that allows an electronic device such as computer or mobile phone to exchange data wirelessly over a network. It provides high speed internet access. This Wi-Fi provides high speed internet access. And hotspot, all of you is very familiar with this hotspot. You can use this in mobile phone to share other devices. WiMAX, it provides wireless accessibility covering many kilometers. This WiMAX, it is also a wireless technology, but it is in larger aspect. It covers many kilometers. Its range is high. The switching techniques. This technique is used in a large networks. It is a hardware or software device which creates a connection between one or more computers. For creating a connection between one or more computers, we need the technique that is called switching technique. It's of three types basically: circuit switching, message switching, and packet switching. Here, in all these three switching technique, the packet switching technique is important than these two, because here it is a method of transferring the data to a network in the form of packets. Transfer the file fast and efficient manner over the network that minimize the transmission latency. Here the data is broken into small pieces of variable length called packets. In message switching, a block of message is transferred from sender to receiver. In circuit switching, two network nodes establish a dedicated communication channel. The network devices, it's very important when we study the network, networking, computer networking, we must know about these devices, because with the help of these devices we connect to the computers and other peripherals. So the hardware devices that are used to connect computers, printer, fax machine and other electronic devices to a network are called network devices. It transfer the data fast and secure in the correct way, same or different network. These are switch, hub, router, bridge and repeater. The first is to switch device in a computer network that connects other devices together. Switch used to create temporary connection between two or more devices. But hub, it is a central device. The best example of hub you can see in your computer lab. Your one hub is kept, and with the help of this hub all the computers are connected in the lab. It is used in star topology. Then router is attached to one or more networks to forward packets from one network to another. It is a device that is used to forward the packets from one network to another. Packets is nothing but the data. Bridge. It is a device used for filtering the data. It checks the destination address and assure that whatever the information is to be sent, it goes to the correct address, right address on packet, and decide whether it should be forwarded or dropped. Then repeater, very important. It increases the power of signal and transmits it, or increasing it works like a amplifier. Also amplifies the signal. It requires a source of electric power. And types of networks, here mainly the three types: LAN, MAN and WAN. Local area network, metropolitan area network and wide area networks are there. The local area network, it that interconnects computers within a limited geographical area. It is generally used in school, laboratory, house, university, campus, these things. And metropolitan area network, the larger than LAN, and it is limited to the city. Within the city it is used. And wide area network, usually used for connecting the computers that spans a wide geographical area. WAN can be used to connect to cities, states or even countries. The global networking, it is also called the global networking of computers, the internet, the WAN. It consists of two or more local area networks. The network layouts, so topology, here it is also called the geographical layout of computers, means how the computers are connected to communicate from one to each other for communication purpose. Here it refers to the way in which a network is laid out physically. The designing of computers, the technology, that network. There are mainly four types of topologies: star, bus, ring and mesh. The most popular topology is star topology. Here star topology is a topology for a local area network in which all nodes are individually connected to a central connection point, like a hub or a switch, like this here. The advantage of this is that, the benefits is that, if a cable fails like this, if suppose this cable is fail, only one node will be brought down, this one only. Rest these all will work, it won't have any effect. So this is the biggest advantage. Second is bus topology. Bus topology is topology for a local area network in which all the nodes are connected to a single cable. Here, this is also called the backbone cable. With the help of single cable, all the computers or nodes are connected. Here, the biggest disadvantage is that if the backbone is broken, the entire segment fails. If something happened wrong to this backbone, all these computers connected with this backbone will stop working. Third is ring topology. A ring topology in which every device has exactly two neighbors. Here you see this computer having one neighbor is this, another is this. So in this topology, each and every device has two neighbors for communication purposes. All messages travel through a ring in the same direction, the one direction, like this. A failure in any cable or device breaks the loop. Suppose if cable is failed to transfer the data, so it will break the loop and the entire segment will stop working. The next topics, network layout. We have self-assessment questions. You read the, go through this PowerPoint presentation, find the answer and note down in your notebook. For each and every module, I will provide you the self-assessment question and it will be helpful for your exam also. So make a notebook from day one, module wise. Thank you. Module is introduction to instant messaging. In the next class.